Since the return of democracy in 1999, the rule of law has taken its course fully with a view to ensure an organized, peaceful and prosperous Nigeria. However, where such laws are not properly publicized and circulated, lack of adherence is inevitable. The National Human Rights Commission believes that the popular saying that ignorance of the law is not an excuse to violating it cannot be fully implemented in Nigeria without infringing on the rights of the citizens. Speaking while inaugurating a working committee on the strengthening of state institutions for the publication, sensitization and circulation of laws in Nigeria, Professor Bem Angwe laments the unauthorized sale of laws enacted by national and state legislators by street hawkers.
How do you punish someone who is not even aware of the existence of a particular penal provision? It is for that reason that the commission has decided to put in place a committee of experts who would first of all identify the particular institutions that do have responsibility, not only to gazette, but to publish and to disseminate amongst Nigerians. Yes, the Nigerian press, the federal government press, may have the responsibility of gazetting the laws promulgated by the National Assembly. Does that responsibility also extend to distributing those laws that are gazetted to Nigerians, for Nigerians to have access to them?
Chairman of the four-member committee, Professor Yemi Akinseye-George, restates the commitment of the committee to address the ignorance of many Nigerians who often suffer misdirection from the purchase of unauthorized laws from street hawkers who sell different versions of the same laws.
In fact, is there anything wrong in having some of our major laws translated into local languages? There are so many Nigerians who have got no job. There are many ways we can proactively engage Nigerians in disseminating access to information about Nigerian laws. And I think availability on the internet is going to be one of the major things that I believe will come out of our recommendations.
The committee is expected to submit its final report by June this year. In Abuja, Joy Uzo, NTA News.